And in this video, we're going to be talking about how to create an ad on Facebook and Instagram. So I get this question a lot. We're actually going to walk you through exactly how to set up your very first ad on Facebook and Instagram coming up. All right, so in this video, we're going to be walking you through step-by-step exactly how to set up an ad in Facebook and Instagram. Okay, so this can be really confusing for a lot of people, but I love this stuff. I'm super passionate about it. In fact, this is what I do for a living, is I literally set up Facebook and Instagram ads for churches all over the country. So I'm going to show you exactly how I do it for all of my clients, and I'll give you my step-by-step framework so that you can do the same thing at yours. All right, so let's dive behind the computer and I'll show you exactly how to set up an ad. All right, so the first thing that you want to do in order to set up an ad is you want to go to facebook.com/ads manager, right? So this is different than a boosted post, and this is different than the ad center. Facebook makes it nice and confusing. So we're not boosting a post. What we're doing is we are actually creating a targeted Facebook ad inside of the ads manager. So you want to go to facebook.com/ads manager, and that's going to take you to a screen that looks like this. Now, Facebook is changing things up all the time. So if some of the things look slightly different whenever you get back here, don't freak out or be alarmed. It's pretty simple, and Facebook's always changing things. So whatever you see this week will probably completely different next week. So in order to start our first ad, and this is going to be for Facebook and Instagram, all we're going to do is we're going to click this green create button. All right, and now we have our choice of what type of campaign that we want to run. So I specifically recommend for churches, you either want to run a traffic campaign or a messages campaign. Right, so messages works great if you're trying to have a conversation with people or have people submit prayer requests or something like that. But it's a little bit more advanced, so for the purposes of this video, we're going to be running a traffic ad, and those are nice and easy to set up on both Facebook and Instagram. And again, we can just set up one ad one time and then run it on both platforms. Pretty cool. So I'll show you exactly how to do that. Okay, so we decided to run a traffic ad, and now we just need to name our campaign. So I'm going to set this one up for a fall festival at the church. So we're just going to call this one Fall Festival Invite. We're going to leave all of this auction traffic. We're going to leave all of that exactly the same. We're not going to do A/B split tests. We'll leave campaign budget optimization off. So we'll click next. And this is going to take us to the ad set level. So we just set up everything on the campaign level, really simple. Okay, so now we're in the ad set level, and we can choose where we want to drive the traffic. So we're driving the traffic from Facebook to somewhere. We want to do a website. You can run it to Messenger. I don't really see too many people go for an app or to WhatsApp, but most of the time I like to just send them straight to my church website. So that's exactly what we're going to do. I'm going to leave these off, dynamic creative and offer. One of the best things about Facebook is that there's no set cost for Facebook ads, right? So you get to choose how much they cost. So literally you can just go in and you can say, hey, we want to spend $5, $10, $20, $30, $100 a day, whatever you want to do. And Facebook will show you based on that, how many people they think your ad is going to reach. So let's just set this just for the heck of it. Let's set it to $10 a day. Okay, so right now we're set up to run to the entire US. Let's change that. What I'm going to do is, because I'm running it to my church, is I'm going to drop in the location of my church. We're going to drop in, there we go. And we're going to run this driving distance of the church. So for me, that's usually about 10 to 15 miles. We'll set this one at 15 miles. And you can see it's actually going to drop a pin right here on my church. And then we're going to run this Facebook ad to everyone who lives within 15 miles of the church, and only people who live within 15 miles of the church. All right, for the targeting, we want to leave the age at 18 to 65 plus, because again, we want to let Facebook's algorithm do all the heavy lifting for us. We don't want to go in and try to guess who we think is going to resonate with this ad. A lot of people make this mistake. So especially churches, we go in and we want to over-target things, right? So say, hey, let's run to everyone between the ages of 25 and 26 who have kids between the ages of 0 and 2 and live within half a mile of the church. Right. And then our potential reach is really, really small because our audience size is so small. Right. So with this right here, if we're running to everybody 18 to 65 plus, we want to keep the targeting completely wide open. And you can see at $10 a day, running to 15 miles of the church, we have a potential reach of 620,000 people that we can run to. Right. So that's pretty good. It's over 500,000. Whenever you can, I like to be between 500,000 and 1 million people. Now, obviously, if you're in a small town, don't worry about it. I run in plenty of small towns. In fact, several that only have a couple thousand people. No problem. Just run them to the people that are in your town. But if you live in a more populated area, don't go more than 1 million and try to get it somewhere in that sweet spot of 500,000 to 1 million. But again, If you live in a small town, you just run it to everybody and don't even sweat it. This is going to work even if you live in a small town. All right, so potential reach 620,000. And this is telling us that Facebook says, well, if we spend $10 a day, we're running to everyone within 15 miles with our targeting wide open, that they estimate we're gonna reach somewhere between 1,300 and 3,700 people. And what I found is this is usually, it's kind of right in the middle, right? So it might be somewhere around 2,300 to 2,500 people per day that are actually gonna see this ad. And link clicks, it's gonna be between 15 and 49. So yeah, we're probably gonna be somewhere in the 30 to 35 clicks per day range. So we'll leave everything else completely wide open, all languages, yes. And then here is where you get to actually choose whether or not you wanna run on Facebook, Instagram, on Messenger, or on the Audience Network, which is a collection of third-party websites and apps that Facebook sometimes runs ads on. So I personally recommend using automatic placements. You're gonna get more bang for your buck, and you're gonna reach a lot more people for less money. But if for some reason there are some placements that you don't want to run on, you could actually go down here, right? So this is what's so cool about Facebook is that you can set up one ad and you can run it on Facebook and Instagram. So this ad that we're setting up is gonna run on both platforms. And right now I have it set up to run on the Audience Network and Messenger. If for some reason, if we wanted to take those off, right now we're running on just Facebook and Instagram, but you can notice our potential audience size has changed as well, right? So if we're running it to all four platforms, we're running at about 620,000. But if we take off Messenger and Audience Network, it's gonna drop it down by about 10,000 people. So nothing crazy. Just for now, let's go ahead and do that. We're gonna run Facebook and Instagram, and we're gonna come down here. We're gonna leave all those placements they've automatically chosen for us as long as it's on those two platforms. And then we're gonna head to our next one. And then we're gonna head to the ad level. All right, and then here, all you wanna do is pick the Facebook page that you wanna run this for. So I'm gonna run this from one of my businesses just to make it easy, but this is where you'd click to make sure it's connected to your church or your business, because whichever Facebook page you have pulled up here is what it's gonna run for. And the cool thing is you don't even have to have an Instagram account. You can actually run from your Facebook page on Instagram. So literally Facebook or Instagram will just say Creative Church Network on Instagram, and it'll look just like it's an Instagram account, even if you don't have one. That's what this use selected page is. Otherwise, you can connect it to your Instagram business page. All right, we're gonna come down here. We're gonna do a single image or video, and we're gonna just gonna click add media, and let's go to add video. Now, I already pre-loaded one of these videos in here, right? So we're gonna grab this video from Amanda, and this is already in here. We are good to go, so we're gonna say done. And then it's gonna show us in all these placements that actually went in here. Now, the one thing that we're gonna do is saying add deliverable to Instagram feed. That's because we uploaded a selfie video. And I like to use selfie videos because they take up more real estate in the newsfeed. So your video is gonna get noticed more. But all we have to do here is just click on this little editing pencil. And all we're gonna do is we're just gonna crop that video. And we're just gonna use the one-to-one recommended. All right, and then I'm gonna bump this up here just to make sure we're getting Amanda's face and not cutting off her head here. Click apply. As soon as this video crop is done processing, all we have to do is save this, and then we can add our ad copy and our headline, our newsfeed description, and then we're ready to roll. All right, so if this video is resonating with you, make sure to subscribe to our channel and hit that little bell so you get notifications. We drop brand new videos, fresh content every single day, 5 days a week. All right, so the video is done processing. So now what we're gonna do here is we are just going to add in our primary text. Now, I already went and kind of grabbed this primary text here. So we're just gonna pop it in there, and this is where you would actually write it. So what we're gonna be doing in this one is we are advertising for a fall festival. All right, so it's, hey, fall festival on Sunday, October 27th at Journey Church. We're hosting our fall festival with tons of free candy and family-friendly events. All right, so wrote some copy in here to reach families and attract parents. And then what we're gonna say is headline, Fall Festival at Journey Church. And then this description isn't gonna get seen very often unless someone is on desktop. So what I like to do is just use the headline for the description as well. All right, now we got our copy and our headline. So the only thing left is our description. This is optional because you're only gonna see this if you're actually on like the desktop newsfeed. But I just like to use the same thing as the headline, so Fall Festival, Journey Church. And now we have that in there. The only thing that we have left to do is to add our website that we want to send all of our traffic to. So for this one, I'm actually just going to send it to, I'm going to type it in. Normally what you would want to do is you actually want to go to your website. So if it's like journeychurch.com/festival, you'd want to go in and actually copy paste that URL in here just to make sure it goes to exactly the right place. But for the sake of time here, I'm just going to type it in and we'll just say journeychurch.com/festival. And when you copy paste it, you're going to have like the HTTP, right? The www. All that stuff. And so just so that that doesn't show up in our ad, what you can do is on the display link, you can actually just shorten it. So we can take off the www.http. We can just say journeychurch.com. We don't need to do /festival. Whatever you put in this box is where people, when they click on the ad, is where it's going to take them to. But over here, we can actually just say, hey, we're just going to take them straight to, this is just the display link that it's actually going to show in the ad. Our call to action is just going to be learn more so that people click on that and then they go to our website to learn a little bit more. And that's it. We created an ad. So we can see right here, this is all of our ad copy. Click on see more. It's going to show all of the ad copy here. Here is the video of Amanda that we uploaded. We've got the learn more button. Here is our headline, Fall Festival at Journey Church. And then here is the display link, journeychurch.com. So all we have to do now is click publish and this video will be live. So after you click publish and the ad goes to Facebook for final approval, this can take anywhere from a couple of minutes up to a day. So usually on average, it takes about an hour or two whenever I typically run an ad. Every once in a while, it might take 12 to 24 hours, but on average, it's just gonna take a couple hours. Every once in a while, you might even launch it and 10 minutes later, it gets approved and it's already running. So just important to know that when you actually hit published, as soon as Facebook is done approving it, your ad will be live and Facebook will start showing it to everyone within driving distance of your church. All right, so if you like this video and you want to learn more about how to use social media and technology to grow your church and reach more people, then I'd recommend checking out our video, How to Grow a Church in the 21st Century, Part 2.